So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new FIFA 21 video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the best way to play with Manchester United at this moment, in my opinion of course. I'm going to show you the best formation, lineup, tactics and instructions. I already made two videos about Manchester United, especially the last one. Not everybody was happy with that because I was playing with Shaw as a centre back and with lots of attacking midfielders, and yeah, not everybody was really happy with that, so I tried a few new things out, and yeah, for my feeling I have a better way to play with Manchester United. First of all, I'm going to show you that, I want to thank you very much for watching. Of course, please drop a like under the video if you think this video is really useful for you. You could also subscribe to my channel, it's free to do. I'm doing lots of tactic videos also for other teams. I'm doing tutorial videos and also some videos with gameplay in it. So if you're interested in that, make sure you will hit that subscribe button. Then we're going to start. The formation that I'm using is the 4-3-3 attacking formation. David De Gea is the goalkeeper. Wan-Bissaka is the right defender, I need to say. Bailly and Lindelof are the center backs. And yeah, this was a bit of a struggle for me because you have other center backs, of course, with where are they? This guy, Duan Zebe, he is a bit faster than Lindelof, but yeah, his defensive stats are not that good. We have Jones, but he is really, really slow. The same for Maguire. 50 pace is really, really too slow for me in this game as a center back. So that's why I don't like to use to play with them. Lindelof is also not that fast with 65, but it's also not that slow. 73 for Bailly is pretty good. So yeah, he is the one that needs to play in my opinion. But Lindelof, yeah, you can discuss about that. I also tried Fosu Mensah with 81 pace. He is a better, faster center back. So if you really like the pace in a center back, you can try him. But yeah, also his defensive stats with 71 is not pretty high. So yeah, keep that in mind. If you only like the pace, you can use him. But yeah, if you also like some defensive stats on your player with the tackling and stuff like that, Lindelof is a better option for me. So you can choose over there. I tried both. And yeah, for my feeling, Lindelof is a bit better because he's a real defender. And yeah, Fosu Mensah is not that good yet. On the left side, we have Telles, of course. I don't think that is a discussion. The central midfielders, Pogba and Fred. Yeah, this is also a bit hard because you don't have a really good defensive midfielder in the squad. Fred can play as a defensive midfielder, but that's not the best thing with this high work rate. So he's also running forward, so keep that in mind. He is going to run forward also. I'm going to show you the instructions. We say stay back while attacking, but sometimes he doesn't care about the instructions or whatever. I don't know what it is. He's just running forward, and I think that's because of his high attacking work rate. The other option, McTominay, also has the high work rate, so you have the same problem with him. His defensive stats are a bit better, but he is slower. His pace is 68, and Fred's pace is 79, so that's why I like to use him. If he's running forward and you lose the ball, because of his pace, he is faster back at the defense because of his pace. Yeah, that's why I like to play him and not with McTominay. Van de Beek can also play as central midfielder, but he has the high attack work rate and the medium defensive one. So that's also a bit of a struggle. And yeah, the other option is Matic. But he has 44 pace. That's way too slow in this game if you really want to face some competition. So this is not an option for me with 44 pace. So I think Fred is the best to play as the most defensive midfielder. But keep in mind that he also can run forward because of his high work rates. Then we have Fernandes. He is the attacking midfielder, of course. Pretty good player. Then the right winger, I'm playing Rashford. Cavani is a striker and Martial is the left winger. I'm using this because of Rashford's weak foot is 4-star, and he is right-footed, and Martial is also right-footed, and his weak star is 3-stars. In most videos, if you are watching me for a longer time, I'm saying I like to play with a left-footed player on the left side and a right-footed player on the right side. So this is not really logic that I'm placing Martial on the left side and Rashford at the right side because his weak foot is better. But I really don't like to give crosses in this with this team. Normally, I really like to give some crosses, high crosses, low crosses, whatever. Doesn't matter that much. But yeah, and then it's better to have a right-footed player on the right side and a left-footed player on the left side. But with this squad, I'm using the cut inside and again in behind instructions. I'm going to show that later. So it's pretty better to have a right-footed player on the left side and a left-footed player on the right side. And with the weak foot of 4 stars, Rashford can shoot really good with his left foot. So that's why I'm using this. Then we're going to the tactics. I choose press after possession loss because with Rashford, with Martial, with Pogba, with Fernandes, you have some good players that can press really good. So if you are losing the ball, they are going to press on your opponent and try to make it as difficult as they can to pass the ball around. So you can recover it really quick most of the times. And yeah, then you can set up a new attack, of course. So press after possession loss is a pretty good way for Manchester United, in my opinion. If you don't like to play some pressure football, you can replace this for balanced, of course. But for me, press after possession loss is pretty good. The width is 5 bars, depth is also 5 bars. Defensive style is balanced. The offensive style, I need to say, is balanced with a width of 8 bars. That's because of the wingers. They are starting really wide. And when there is a good opportunity to cut inside and get in behind the opponent's defense, they will make a run inside and surprise your opponent with their runs. Watch them when they are making the runs. Give them some through balls, especially Rashford with his pace. Martial is also pretty fast, but Rashford, he's extremely fast. So watch him to make the runs, give them some through balls, and create your one-on-one goalkeeper chances that way. Players in the box, 6 bars. Corners and free kicks are both 3 bars. Then we're going to the instructions, really important as always. Stay back while attacking for Wan-Bissaka. Both center backs are just default. Telles also stay back while attacking. And I'm doing that because Lindelof is a bit slow for my feeling. And it could be that all your three midfielders are going forward because Fred's high attacking work rate. So if also your fullbacks will go forward and all your midfielders are going forward, you only have these two guys. And that's not what you want because then you are really, really weak on the counter-attack for your opponent. So stay back while attacking for both fullbacks is really necessary in this squad. Pogba, balanced attack. Everything is balanced for him. Only thing that I will change, I didn't do that yet, but it's cover center. So he has the high attacking work rate, so he will go forward himself, and with the balanced attack he will do that, but not all the time because I already said it could be that Fred also is going forward. So balanced attack for Pogba, not get into the box for the cross. That's what I like to play with Pogba lots of times. I'm doing that in the French squad, of course, but then he has Kante next to him, and that's a really good defensive midfielder, and we don't have that in this squad. So Pogba balanced attack and balanced crossing runs, so not all the time going forward. Fred, stay back while attacking, stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center. These are the instructions. That's the only thing you can do to try him to keep back and not running forward all the time, but I don't know why sometimes he's going forward anyway. So yeah, that's what it is, and kept that in mind. Then we have Fernandes. The only thing I changed for him is free roam. He's a pretty good player, and yeah, he can do whatever he wants, going to the left, going to the right, stay in the midfield. Sometimes it's a bit of a surprise for your opponent and also for me. Then he shows up somewhere in the field and I think, wow, that's a pretty good run. So use that, keep that in mind. Then we have Rashford. Only thing I changed for him is cut inside, get in behind and get into the box for the cross. So when there is a really good opportunity, he will make those runs. Watch him to make the runs and give him these through balls. Then we have Cavani, a really good striker, of course. The only thing I changed for him is stay central. And then we have Martial, the same as Rashford. Cut inside, get in behind and get into the box for the cross. So if you watched my second video, I hope this one is better for you, and I hope you will win with this, of course. I'm gonna say something about the substitutes. Some guys asked me from who should I use as a substitute. So for my feeling, you can sub Fred around the 60s or 70 minutes for McTominay. You can replace Van de Beek for Pogba or Fernandes. Depends a bit on who is most tired. I always like to replace the most tired players. Most of the time that will be Pogba because he's making lots and lots of meters. So you could place Van de Beek for Pogba. And the latest substitute that I will make is James for Martial. And then you can switch Rashford and James if you like that. So you have a fresh attacking player with his pace 95. That's really amazing for a substitute because your opponent is already tired also, especially the fullbacks when he is let him run forward, and then you can surprise your opponent with a fresh attacker and yeah, lots and lots of chances one-on-one on the goalkeeper if you watch him make those runs. So that's it for this video. I hope you like it. I hope you will try it out. Please let me know in the comments what you think of it. And if you tried it out, what your results are, I'm really curious about that. And hopefully we will see you next time. Have a really great day. Bye bye.